Subhanallah. Whatever you've done, what, no matter how old you are, no matter what gender you are, no matter where you come from, your race, whatever you have done against Allah's instruction, if it makes you regret, you still have a lot of hope in the mercy of Allah. It's a sign of iman. إِذَا سَرَّتْكَ حَسَنَتُكَ وَسَاءَتْكَ سَيِّئَتُكَ فَأَنْتَ مُؤْمِنٌ. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in one narration says, when your good deed makes you happy, makes you calm, makes you feel good, and when your bad deed makes you regret, then you're a true believer. It shows that you believe in Allah. That's why you're regretting the sin. That's why you're feeling good about the good deed you did. If you didn't regret it, it means you've got no one you're answerable to. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves it when you regret your sin. You committed something, you drank alcohol, you had a bit of a drug, may Allah safeguard all of us. Whatever wrong you've done, immediately thereafter you say, astaghfirullah, I shouldn't have done this. May Allah forgive me, I shouldn't have done this. So you regret it, you feel remorse. That's what happened to Adam alayhi salam. Then he said a few words unto Allah. In one verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that he taught him some words. And in another verse, Allah says, تَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ. You see, the words were taught by Allah, they were repeated by Adam alayhi salam, and he said these words. What were these words? Subhanallah. These are some of the most powerful words. We all need these words. رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Oh Allah, oh our Rabb, you know, oh our Rabb, رَبَّنَا, oh our Rabb. What is the meaning of رَبٌ? Rabb is the one who created you in the first place and who has absolute control of every aspect of your existence. He's called رَبٌ. All your growth depends totally on Him. Your food, your sustenance, your health, whatever, you know, He nourishes, cherishes, provides, protects and cures, etc., etc. That's رَبٌ. So that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَبَّنَا, oh our Rabb, oh our Rabb. Sometimes if you're alone, you can say Rabbi, Rabbi meaning my Rabb. And Rabbi without the Ya also refers to my Rabb. Because in the Arabic language, you are allowed to drop that Ya when it comes to Rabbun, Rabbi. So here he says, رَبَّنَا, ظَلَمْنَا. We have oppressed أَنفُسَنَا, ourselves. We have wronged ourselves. Oh Allah, we are the ones who perpetrated a sin. We committed a crime. We did something wrong. We did something we were not supposed to do. That is the meaning of ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا. وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا. And if you are not going to forgive us, وَتَرْحَمْنَا. And if you are not going to have mercy on us, لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. We are the ones who will definitely be the losers. You're not going to lose anything. We will lose. That dua is seeking forgiveness of Allah. It's the proper way of asking Allah's forgiveness. It was taught to Adam alayhi salam by Allah. It was repeated by Adam alayhi salam. Allah forgave him as a result, but he was sincere, there was remorse, and he did not do it again.